Hi, my name's Josh. I've got a question for both of you. The end of Mark being Mark 16:8, from the presentation, there's what's known as the short version and the long version. Can you tell me, so the long version being Mark continuing from verses 9 to 20, which of those do you, like, what manuscripts do you look at to determine if Mark should end at 8 or if it should continue on to verses 9 to 20?
On this question, there really is no serious debate. The longer ending is later. It shows evidence of knowing Matthew and Luke. It's correcting a perceived problem in the text, and it does appear relatively early. It appears in the second century already. But the most trustworthy manuscripts don't have it, and if they knew of it, they surely would have included it. Good question.
Do you agree with that assessment?
Yeah, I do. You'd be hard-pressed. Well, is this on? Yeah. You'd be hard-pressed to find a scholar today who thinks that the longer or shorter ending of Mark is authentic. They believe that Mark ends with chapter 16, verse 8. But the question is why? And it is so awkward. Now, there's certainly no consensus on the answer why it ends that way. In fact, there are probably more explanations out there on why it ends that way than there are New Testament scholars positing them. My guess is that Mark's ending was lost, is what I think. You have Jesus. I think that it's historical, that he predicted his imminent death and resurrection. I've written on this. I've published on it. So I do think that it is historical that he predicted his death and resurrection. And we have some decent evidence for the resurrection of Jesus. So why would Mark end there? I think it was probably lost. Or for some reason, maybe he was in prison or he got sick and was unable to complete it. We just don't know.